video. In the previous video, we learned to find the median of grouped data. Today, we will see an interesting example based on the median of grouped data. The following frequency distribution shows the pocket money of 100 students in a class. If the average pocket money of the students is 62, can you find the number of students X and Y? Let's try to solve it. Since we know that the median is obtained only when we are given the cumulative frequency in the distribution table. So, let's construct the cumulative frequency for this distribution table, which we will denote in the third column. It is given that the total number of students is 100. Therefore, the value of the last line of the cumulative frequency 70 plus x plus y will be equal to the total number of students, which we represent by equation 1. If we talk about the median, we can see from the median formula, L, or the lower limit of the median class, N, which is the total number of students, CF, or the cumulative frequency of the class just before the median class, F, or the frequency of the median class, and H, that is class size, will be required. Its median class is 60 to 70 because 62 belongs to this class, whose low limit is 60, class size is 10, frequency is 20, and the total number of students is 100. And we also know that the cumulative frequency of the class just before the median class is CF, whose value is 32 plus X. Putting all these values in the median formula, we get 14 as the value of X. Since we have to find the number of students X and Y, can you tell the value of Y? Well done. Putting the value of X in equation 1, the value of Y is obtained as 16. So we can say that the number of students X and Y will be 14 and 16 respectively. So hopefully you would have understood how to find the median of grouped data. Teachers can also test students' understanding in the classroom with the help of some such examples.